For as long as the spark shines over these lands, pain is locked inside every soul. Escape these lands. To a place where the keeper has no dominion over them. Souls turned black, who gave in to their desires. Even they believe. But the Keeper won't ever let them go. Thank you. feeds the pain they harvest and nurture and steal. And even more so, the pain they suffer themselves. No one can leave while the Keeper still needs them. The secret of the flowers lives on. Those who live in the light of their flower are free from pain and hidden from the Keeper's ever-vigilant gaze. The flower fills their hearts with love, and the love stands in the way of the pain, since the Keeper no longer has use for it. But those who serve the Keeper can never have their own soul flower. There is no escape for them, for black are their souls. Even if you steal a flower, it'll never be yours. Such things should never happen. Flowers must stay with those who gave them life.
He never was a knight, you know. One way or another, we all serve the Keeper. And we all have our desires. Most importantly, his heart was not all black. He had grown his own sunflower. He did not manage to save it, though. And that was his undoing. And she, well, she never forgave him. But yes, he did steal that second flower. There is something you do not know, though. You were too young then, and no one told you. Everyone was so busy, so preoccupied with their own pain. He stole the flower from death. Stole you away. And accepted you with all his heart. She couldn't, though. She blamed him. She blamed you. Some have to face more pain than they can handle. And the pain broke her. She wanted them to leave together. To follow their flower. And that night, they did leave. She took him with her. She took my son. Pain stays with us forever. It can subside. It may grow dull, but it'll never leave us. And we live with it, doing our best not to let it dissolve us. We fight it every day. But there are different kinds of pain. There's sacrificing yourself. The father, consumed by work, trying to give his child a better future. The mother, dedicating herself to her family until there is nothing left of her. Your pain is the price you pay to make someone else feel better. To make someone else smile, if only for a moment. But trading someone else's happiness for your pain is not the only way. Life doesn't want your pain. It doesn't need your suffering. It simply is what it is. You don't have to fight it. All we can do is remember those who are gone and do our best for those who remain. All of us carry our pain within us. Another way, even if you're in pain, another way is to take someone else's pain and make it your own.
Do you remember? Do you remember it? That tale about pain? I was wrong. It's a tale about love. I will tell you. Tell you once again.